Listen here. No matter where you are in life, mentally, physically, emotionally, or financially, I want you to know that now is the acceptable time. Right now, at this very moment in your life, is the time for you to make a change. Time waits for no man. So stop waiting to make your next move and just do it. Procrastination is a fertilizer that makes difficulties grow. Therefore, stop procrastinating and stop lying to yourself saying, oh, I'll do it tomorrow, or I'll do it later on, because the only person you're fooling is yourself. Tomorrow is the only day of the year that appeals to a lazy man. While you wasting time saying, I'm gonna get to it tomorrow, it's somebody getting ahead of you in life doing it right now. You gotta be self-motivated and hungry out there. Ain't no time to be lazy. Know your strengths and weaknesses in life. Sharpen and fine-tune your strengths while eliminating your weaknesses. The Bible says that if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you can tell a mountain to move and it'll move. Therefore, stop doubting. The problem with a lot of people today is they got a goal or a dream that they really want to accomplish. But when they look at the magnitude of how far-fetched the goal or dream may seem, they back down from the challenge. They get scared. You got to eliminate all doubt, fear, and negativity from your mind. If you are dealing with a mountain or obstacle in your life right now, it's three things that I want you to do. I want you to command it to move, believe it will move, and then start putting it in action to make it move. The Bible also says that faith without works is dead. With that being said, it don't matter how badly you want something, how much you pray for something, or how much you hope for something, it will never come your way if you don't put in work. I'm a big believer of energy. I believe you are the company you keep. So if you are around a bunch of people who are small-minded, negative, and can't see your goals or dreams as being feasible, then why are you even around? For example, if you tell your friend right now, I'm gonna be the first person to build a car that can both drive and fly, and your friend's response to you is, oh man, that's impossible. Well then, in my opinion, it should be impossible for that person to continue to be your friend. That type of person won't build you. They are no use for you, and they will never think on the level that you think on. You gotta surround yourself with people who are positive and on the same wave as you. My thing is this. We as humans are only given one life to live on Earth. One life to accomplish whatever goals or dreams you want to accomplish and leave whatever legacy you're gonna leave behind. With that being said, since we are only given one life to live here on Earth, that essentially means that your goals and your dreams are literally to die for. If you haven't accomplished your goals and your dreams in life, or if you're not spending every brief moment of your life to accomplish your goals and your dreams, then you didn't live a life worth living. Your life simply passed you by because you didn't allow yourself the opportunity to reach your full potential. And that's crazy. You should never do that. God made life simple and sweet. Life being hard is something that we tell ourselves when we feel overwhelmed by life and we need an excuse. Living your life to the fullest ain't hard, it's a mindset. You gotta program your heart and your mind to know that no matter the trial, tribulation, or obstacle that you may face in life, nothing, and I mean absolutely nothing, will stop you from reaching your full potential. Here's how simple God made life, and I want everybody watching to really try this. If you are having problems mentally or emotionally, I want you to just pray. Talk to God and see if you don't start feeling better. If you are having problems physically, I want you to go work out. Set a goal and a vision for how you want your body to look, and then go kill your workout to get that outcome. And here's the one I love the most. If you are looking for financial freedom, I want you to evaluate yourself and explore. Find out what you feel is your biggest God-given talent. Once you found out what your niche and your biggest God-given talent is, then you found your moneymaker. There's an old saying that I believe is very true still to this day. The saying goes like this. Find something that you love to do so much and something that you are so passionate about that you will happily do it for free. And once you learn to do it well, somebody will gladly pay you for it. In life, things only happen when you take action. Though you may stumble and you may fall, that's the risk you gotta take to eat greedy or don't eat at all.